Well, so guys, here we go with the tangents chapter. So there are a few more properties. There are some three more properties that we are going to learn, the new ones. And besides this, we'll also be using all the properties that you have done in the previous chapter. So you can assume that this chapter is an extension to the previous chapter basically. So again, the chapter is easy. It's just that it's going to take some time to get a hang of it. Okay, so I'll tell you first the property number one. In the property number one, I'll just draw the figure first. So say here we have a circle. There is a circle and there is a line which is touching the circle. So here we have a circle and there is a line which is touching the circle at one point. Then, so let's say, so this line which is touching the circle at one point is basically called as what? Tangent. So say here, this is a tangent AB which is touching the circle at a point, say T. And the center of the circle out here is say P. So the theorem states that if I join the line from the center to the point where you've drawn a tangent, if you join those, then this line is perpendicular to the tangent. Got it? So you can draw a tangent anywhere to this circle and join that point where you've drawn a tangent to the circle. For example, say if I have drawn here like this and this is a tangent, then this angle will be 90 degree. That's what the theorem states. So in simple words, it states that radius is perpendicular to tangent. So this reason what I'm giving you is in simple terms. The actual statement what is given in the textbook is that the tangent at any point of a circle and the radius through this point are perpendicular to each other. So if you remember, you can write this, otherwise you can write in simple words this only directly, which all the schools accept: the radius is perpendicular to the tangent. So this is our property number one. Now next, property number two. So again, for property number two, I'll just draw the circle first and okay, now in this property, it says that if there is a point, say for example, I'm considering this point, which is outside the circle. So from this point, if I'm trying to draw a tangent to the circle here, then you can draw only two tangents to the circle. You cannot draw more than this. As you can check, try to draw one more and it will pass through the circle, or it may not touch the circle. So it says that you can draw only two tangents from a point which is outside the circle. So let's say the point is P, this point is A, and this point out here is B, and that's the center of a circle, say O. Now, so first thing is what? That you can draw only two tangents from an external point, and those two tangents will be equal to each other. Okay, so you can draw only two tangents and those two tangents will be what? Equal to each other. So what's the statement that we need to write over here? That tangents drawn from an external point, tangents drawn from an external point to the circle are equal. As I always tell you, you also must write down these properties, draw these figures simultaneously in your notebook, so it will get easy for you to remember. And before you start any problems, make sure that you know all these statements. Okay? In fact, learn them, write 5 times so that you remember it well, guys. And if possible, you can use different colors like I'm using. So whatever is marked in red, that's the result. Now guys, property number 3. So actually we are not going to use this property. I mean, in the first few problems we are only going to use first and second property, but I'll discuss the third property also right now only. So third property is the only one which is little challenging to understand. So again, let's say here you've got a circle, then there is a tangent to the circle, so that is going to touch the circle at one point, and from the point where the tangent is drawn, from there is another chord out here, and opposite to that chord here there is another circle. And this, so guys, from here we are drawing that. I'll just draw that other tangent, sorry, the angle opposite to the chord. Now let's name this. So say this is again, I'll name this as point, say P, this is Q and R, and the tangent is A and B. So this theorem is popularly known as alternate segment theorem. That's a short form, alternate segment theorem. Now a lot of people, they misunderstand, because there is an alternate, they think of alternate angles in this. So remember, there are no alternate angles, nothing out here. What does alternate segment theorem states? Now it states that the angle which is formed, okay, look at this now properly, this is a bit confusing, the angle which is formed between the tangent, so between the tangent and the chord, is it clear? The angle which is formed between the tangent and the chord is equal to the angle which is opposite to this chord. So what is that angle which is opposite to this chord? That will be what? That will be this angle out here. Got it? So we can say what? That angle BPQ is equal to angle PRQ. I'll repeat again, that angle have to be at the circumference, not at the center. Use the similar logic and tell me that this angle out here will be equal to which angle. So again, first find out that this is the angle formed between the tangent and the chord. Now what is the angle opposite to this chord out there? So it will be which angle? This angle out here. Got it? So I can also say that angle APR is equal to angle PQR. What is the reason for these statements? It is alternate segment theorem. Okay, so guys, we'll start with the problems now. So the first problem, I'll have to draw the figure first. Okay, so guys, the first problem what we are doing, that problem is pretty long. It's also a little tough also. I'll have to draw the circle inside this now. It's a freehand circle, so it's a little bit data and all. This angle is given as 90 degree. That's the center of the circle, say O. The triangle is named ABC, and it touches the circle, touches the sides at points P, Q and R. So first thing out here, I will have to do, okay, now what are the measurements? So the measurements which are given to you is that this side is equal to 7 centimeter. This side is given to us as 24 centimeter. So guys, everything that I've marked in black is all given to us. Now construction. So what all construction I need to do? Join PO, join OQ. So first, guys, what will you write in the answer? Guys, it's going to be very long, the statement. So what you can do is, you can, as I keep telling you, you can keep writing the statement simultaneously. You may pause the video as an in between when you need to. So now the first statement is that the radius is perpendicular to tangent. Radius is perpendicular to the tangent. So OP बी इज 90 डिग्री, ओ क्यू बी इज 90 डिग्री बिकॉज रेडियस इज परपेंडिकुलर टू टेंजेंट. इफ थ्री एंगल्स इन अ क्वाड्रिलेटरल आर 90 डिग्री, देन दैट क्वाड्रिलेटरल इज अ रेक्टेंगल. बट आई कैन ऑल्सो से दैट ओ पी इज इक्वल टू ओ क्यू. वॉट विल बी द रीजन? रेडियाई ऑफ द सर्कल. Now, if adjacent sides are equal in a rectangle, then that turns out to be what? Square. So, this is one major part of the problem to prove that that quadrilateral is a square. Okay? This is one part. Now, because it's a square, so all sides are equal now. So, all of them are equal. Let these equal sides in each be what? X. Can you tell me how much would be Q to C? This. So, it will be 7 minus x because total was 7. Same way, how much would be this side? So, it will be what? 24 minus x. Now, we can say that the tangents drawn from an external point are equal, right? So, notice that CQ is equal to CR because tangents drawn from an external point are equal, that property. Which was the property number 2 that we did today. So, these also becomes what? 7 minus x. Same way, this side is equal to this side. What will be the reason? Tangents from an external point are equal. Now, what will be this full side? Okay, what is the side AC? So, the side AC is equal to 25 centimeter. How? By Pythagoras theorem. Remember, we are getting that as 25 centimeter because of Pythagoras theorem. Now, what we can do is that AR plus RC is equal to AC. So, AR is 24 minus X, RC is 7 minus X, AC is 25. So, 31 minus 2X is equal to 25. 2x is equal to 6, x is equal to 3 centimeter. So, therefore, what is the radius of the circle, which is equal to 3 centimeter? I forgot to mark the sum. Sum number 1, you can mark it as a Dhasu problem. So, of course, after solution, you will not find it tough. But the challenge is, one, to remember the method, and second thing is to write the statements. So, there are going to be too many statements, guys, if you are writing it properly. So, I advise that usually if it comes in section 2, it's better to avoid this problem if you've got better options. Otherwise, attempt it when you don't have any choice. Okay, now next problem. Problem number 2. Okay, so guys, out here, the question is, okay, let's see what is the question first. They are asking you to calculate the angle subtended. Okay, what do you have to calculate? The angle subtended by AB at the center of the circle. So, what does this mean first of all? Angle subtended by AB at the center of the circle. So, see out here now, look, I'll just magnify this figure so it gets easy for you to understand. What do you mean by angle subtended at the center? So, they basically mean this is your AB right here. So, the angle that it subtends at the center will be which angle? You know, this angle. So, this is the angle which you need to find out. Now, to make this little easier for you to understand, I am just drawing, extending this tangent further so you can make it out easily that it's a tangent. Now, let's start all the problems out here, guys. So, first, so let's start marking now all the angles. So, guys, whenever if you're not getting anything, do one thing, just start marking the angles. Whatever angles you can find, just find out. Like, for example, I can find out this angle over here, which is by what? Sum of angles in a triangle is 180, that property. Correct? If somebody does not know this, they should commit 4 times suicide, guys. So, 48 and 36, you add and then subtract from 180 degree. So, it will come how much? 96, is it? Okay, 96 degree. So, we found this by what? Sum of angles in a triangle is equal to 180 degree. Now guys, angle OCT, okay, look at this, angle OCT is equal to 90 degree. Guess the reason. Why is this 90 degree? Because radius is perpendicular to tangent. So how much is this angle, this remaining angle? 42, because 90 minus 48. Now we have to find out this angle. How we can find this angle? So radii of a circle are equal. So this becomes 42. Now I can find out this angle. Why? How? Because sum of all these angles together should be equal to what? 180 degree. Angles forming a straight line. So on solving, these two will come to how much? 42 degree. Now again, radii of a circle are equal. So this also becomes what? 42. Now 42 and 42 is what? 84. So this angle will become what? 96 degree. Clear? So that is 96 degree out here. So we had asked to find angle BOA, and we found that angle BOA is equal to 96 degree. Okay. Then now next problem, guys. So guys, here is a next problem. You are given the figure, and whatever is given, data is given in the question is already marked out here. I will just mark what you have to find out. So you are asked to find angle QOP. So that's the angle they are asking us to find out. And angle QCP, and this is the other angle which they have asked us. Okay, now see, let's start from here. We'll find out all these angles now. So first thing, guys, again, I'll just extend these tangents because otherwise it gets a little difficult to understand how these tangents are going. So this is one tangent here and that's the other tangent. So even in the exam, if it is difficult for you to understand, always extend those tangents. It makes a little easier to imagine that figure then. So these are your tangents. So now let's find out. So first, which angles can we find out? You can see they have given the two sides equal, right? This sides and this sides, they have given us equal. So what we can say out there is because of the, it's given. So the base angles are equal. So how much will be this base angle? It will be 180 minus 68. So that's 112. And I have to again divide by 2 because there are two equal angles. So this will come 56 degree. Can somebody find out what will be angle POQ? So look, how to find out angle POQ? So you see, this is the arc. So that's the central angle and that's the angle at the circumference. So angle at the circumference is half of central angle. Use that property and you will get this angle is what? 112. Now, what is the reason for angle OPC is equal to angle OQC is equal to 90 degree? What would be the reason for it? Radius perpendicular to tangent. Radius perpendicular to the tangent. Now, can you find angle PCQ? Angle PCQ will be equal to 360 minus 90, 90 and 112. So when you subtract all these angles, you will get 68 degree. So that's your final answer. So okay, these are the problem what we've done now. These are like the most common type of problems that they have been asking in the exams. Okay. Now another problem, which is also there in your textbook, guys, but I think this problem has been placed over here by mistake because that looks more like a sum of it's actually a sum of quadratic equation. Yeah, not does it look like. It is a sum of quadratic only. But by mistake, they have placed over here in this textbook. So I'll just tell you the figure question first. For now, it may look like some cartoon character to you. little bit. Okay. So now first, there are these three circles which are touching each other, and the centers of these circles are P, Q and R. So center of this circle is what? P. Then center of this circle is what? Q. And center of this circle is R. Now let's say I'll just join all the three centers. As I've been telling you, whatever I'm marking in black is all the part of the question, so that all data is already given to us. It is also given to us that this angle is 90 degree. Now, see, I'll tell you what all data is given to us. You're given that the radius of this circle is 9 centimeter. So this is given as 9, okay, of this circle. The radius of the shorter circle is given to us as 2 centimeter. And we are asked to find the radius of this circle, the biggest circle. So let it be what? X. Let this also be what? X. Now notice one thing. These are radii of the circle, so they have to be equal. This is radii of the circle, so this will also be 9. Sorry, I don't need to mark that actually. Yeah, you don't need anything else. Now, you are also given in the question that PQ is equal to 17 centimeter. So this whole side is given to you 17 centimeter. You must have got it now actually. You have to basically what you have to apply? Quadratic equation. So remember what we are going to do guys here? Quadratic equation. So apply Pythagoras theorem. So we'll say what that in triangle PRQ. In triangle PRQ, PR squared plus RQ squared is equal to PQ squared. What would be the reason we'll write here? By Pythagoras theorem. What is PR squared? So that is X plus 9 the whole squared. What is RQ squared? So it is X plus 2 the whole squared, which is equal to 17 squared. Solve for X out here, and the value of X you will guess at 6 centimeter. So guys, actually there is a, you will get so first thing you must have made out that this diagram is not to scale, and second thing, you will not get just one answer, you'll get two answers, you'll get one more answer, but the thing is that answer will be you'll get a negative answer, so it is not possible. I mean, since it's a quadratic equation, you'll get two options out there. Okay, now I'll present the next question to you. This one is, guys, one of the very, very important type of a question from exam point of view. So usually this is the standard type of question that they ask you. First, just figure out what is asked in the question. Whatever data is given, it's already marked, and they're asking you to prove BC is equal to CD. So we are asked to prove BC. You're asked to prove BC is equal to BD. I think I said CD by mistake. You have to prove this too. BC equal to BD. Now, how to prove this, guys? So look here. I'll just, one sec. Yeah, here. So guys, let's find out the angles first. Okay, this is all given to us. So whatever I'm finding now, I'm marking it in blue. And this is what we are asked to prove. The one which are marked in red. So first property is that this angle is 90 degree. What is the reason? Angle inscribed in a semicircle is a right angle. How much is this angle? Sum of angles in a triangle 180. So it becomes 60. What would be this adjoining angle? So it'll be what? 120 linear pair. Now, guys, you'll first find out this angle. Just think about it. Which property will you apply? Think and find out that angle. I'll give you a hint. So the property which we did today, and I said it's very, very important, that property. So the property is what? That it's called as what? Alternate segment theorem. So you can see that's the arc, right? That's the angle between the tangent and the chord. And this is the angle opposite to the chord. So this angle is called, will be how much? It will be 30 degree, alternate segment theorem. Again use SAT property, sum of angles in a triangle 180, you will get this also is 30 degree. Now if both the base angles are 30 degree, okay, if both the base angles are 30 degree, then obviously the sides will also be equal, isosceles triangle property. So these are all 3-3, 4-4 marks problems, guys, which are asked in your exams. Okay, next problem, which is also a little similar to this only, we'll try that one now. So in this problem, they are asking us to prove something. Now you have to show something out here. So what do we need to show? That x plus 2y is equal to 90. You have to prove this. Okay, with this given data. So again, let's start over here. One second, I'll just present guys this question. So let's find out the angles now. Guys, see, there's a, you may, if you want to try first yourself, pause it and then try further. And I'm doing one another method, so listen to me properly. This is the shortest method that I'm doing. You may get this method, same method, or you may be trying some another method, that's okay. But see, listen to this method properly now. First, this angle is equal to 90 degree. What will be the reason? Angle inscribed in a semicircle is a right angle. Now, how much would be this angle? Find out this angle first. So what is that angle? It is the angle, first see, the angle formed between the tangent and the chord is how much? Y. So what will be angle opposite to that chord equal to? Also equal to what? Y. Got it? So this turns out to be what? Y. Now notice this properly. Now we'll consider this triangle, look, P, R, S. This is the triangle now we are talking about. So in triangle P, R, S, what are all the angles that we are, that are there? So there is an angle X here. Then there is a Y plus 90 degree, that is P, R, S. And there is an another angle Y out here, that is angle S, which is Y. And all this total is equal to 180 degree. Why? Because of sum of angles in a triangle is 180. Add them, x plus 2y is equal to 90 over, hence proved. So guys, ideally, first step was 90 degree, second was alternate segment, and third is SAT property, and it finished. So it's a 4 mark problem, but almost only 3 steps are there in this one. This is also very important, guys, this problem. Now, next problem, 11th one. In the 11th problem, guys, again, if you all want to try, you can just pause the video always. So here, what are we asked to prove? First, see what is given in this question. PA is equal to AM. This is given to us, guys. So I'll just mark it in the picture. PA is equal to AM. It basically means that this angle is X and this angle is also equal to what? X then. Now, what do you have to prove in this? So first you have to prove what? That it is an isosceles triangle. PMB is an isosceles triangle. That's a big triangle they are talking about. PMB, this one. Second thing, you have to prove PA into PB equal to MB squared. But this is not in your portion for now. It's cancelled. So we are just going to prove this, and mostly you will get it on your own only, this one. So I'll just ask you, first do one thing. First tell me how much is this angle and what is the reason. So this will be alternate segment theorem X. Correct? Angle formed between the tangent and the chord is equal to the angle opposite to the chord. So it's already done though. So now therefore PM is equal to MB. So it's an isosceles triangle because base angles are equal. Done. Doesn't look like it'll come in your exam, guys. Then another problem. Next one, guys, I'll have to draw that problem here. So guys, this is the data available, and this is a little challenging problem. You can mark this problem as a Dasu problem. Now, OA is equal to 17 centimeters. So, what is OA first? From here to here, this is OA, which is equal to 17. Now, in this problem, I can say that this is 90 degree. Reason, radii of a circle are equal. So, this is given 17 and radius is given 8. So, I can also find out AP now by Pythagoras theorem. So, by Pythagoras theorem, you will get AB as how much? It will come 15 centimeter AP. Okay. Now, I can also say that AB, AP is also equal to AQ. Okay, guys, this is going to be a little tough one. Like, you need to understand it well now. So, first statement, so I'll write the statements here, that AP is equal to AQ is equal to 15 centimeter. So, if you remember, tangents from an external point to the circle are equal. Let's write the whole statement. I'm not able to write here because of the lack of space. So that's 15 centimeter. Second thing. Now we can also say that BP is equal to BR. Okay, now see, BP is equal to BR. Reason, same reason, tangents of an external point. So this part is equal to this. This part is equal to this. Also, CR is equal to CQ. Again, tangents from an external point are equal. Got it? Now guys, see, what is the perimeter of triangle ABC? What do you mean by the perimeter? Sum of all the three sides. So AB plus BC plus CA. Now what I can do is, in place of BC, see now, notice the picture properly. In place of BC, what I'll do is, I'll just break up them into two parts. So what is BC made up of? It is made up of two parts. That is what? BR and RC. And plus CA. So what I've done out here is, basically, instead of BC, I wrote its parts, BR and RC. Now, I'm just grouping it further. See now, how to group this. I'll write AB plus BR in one bracket and RC plus CA in other bracket. Now what will be AB plus BR plus RC plus CA? Okay, so now let's replace, guys. AB plus, what is BR equal to? Look at this, BR is equal to what? BP plus RC is equal to what? CQ plus CA. Now check the figure. What is AB plus BP equal to? So AB plus BP is equal to what? This. That is what? AP. What will be CQ plus CA equal to? That is again what? This side. So now what can I write here? AB plus BP is what? AP. CQ plus CA is what? AQ. And AP and AQ both are 15. So you just add up 15 and 15. So your total answer is what? 30 centimeter. Guys, this might have taken some effort to understand. Okay. Now guys, next problem, I think there are some problems in the exercise, so I'll tell you which I'll mark and send you the problem which you're supposed to do. So only do those problems, because all of them are not there in your portion, and whatever problems are difficult and all, so I'll discuss in the class, or I'll make another video for that. Okay, so we are done for this now.